In SwiftUI, you have navigation link for navigating between views in a navigation stack. But there's no direct equivalent for presenting sheets, which is a common way to present modals. While navigation link automatically manages navigation state, presenting a sheet often requires more manual state handling. In this video, I show you how to create a custom solution that mimics navigation link's functionality for sheets, making your SwiftUI code more intuitive and reusable. This tutorial is part of SwiftUI Camp. This is just a small bit of what you will learn in SwiftUI Camp. 4 weeks, hands-on, Zoom meetings. Go ahead and check it out. We have an 80% off discount link in the description down below. Okay, so we are going to learn about a new thing that is called navigation sheet. Now, of course, I came up with that, but let me just show you why I came up with that. So we are having here just a plain, simple, vanilla Xcode project. Let me just add a navigation stack into the app. So navigation stack, so we could just navigate. Okay, there we go. And then let's go back to the content view. And now we have access to the navigation link. Of course, we want to add that also into the preview because I'm just going to use the preview. So navigation stack. Okay, so now if we are using the navigation link within our content view, it will just basically work. So I'm just going to create here a destination view just so we can just navigate somewhere. So view, let's just create a view, my view. Let's just call this destination view. Okay, and let's just have a text of destination view. Great. So this is where we would just navigate away. I'm removing that preview so we won't have any clutter. So how do we navigate? Of course, we are navigating. Let me just move this with a navigation link. And I'm just going to go with the simplest one for now. Destination and label. The destination would be our destination view, of course. And the label, let's just have a text of a navigate to a destination. That's really great. So let's just check it out. There we go. Simple as that. SwiftUI Camp is the best way to skyrocket your SwiftUI knowledge because it offers a comprehensive, hands-on learning experience packed into just 4 weeks. You will dive deep into essential topics like building views, managing data, working with Codable, and mastering navigation, all through interactive Zoom meetings. This boot camp is designed to accelerate your learning with real-time guidance and practical projects, helping you become a SwiftUI pro in no time. Check out the link down in the description. Okay, but what happens if I want to have a sheet? Well, that's a little bit different. We want to have a button, and on that button, we want to have a sheet view modifier. Let's do that. So let's just have a button right over here, title, and that would be like maybe sheet. Yeah, that's fine, sheet. And then we want to have a state variable like, let me just copy out the name of the destination view, and we would say at state private var is presented, but not just is presented, is destination view presented. So we are going to toggle that on the tap of the button, is destination view presented dot toggle. And then we are going to add a dot sheet is presented with a content. So let's just use that one. And I think auto completion is generating the right code right over here. So let's see that. Tap on the sheet. There we go. We are on the destination view. If we tap on the navigation link, navigate to destination, we have that one. Okay. Now you see that we have two different ways of navigating, and we have two different APIs, which is kind of a shame because we have the navigation link. Why can't we have something similar for the sheet type of navigation, not using this kind of awkward view modifier? So that is what we are going to build out today. We are going to create a navigation sheet. So let's start right over here. Let's create a simple view. It will be called navigation sheet. Let me remove the preview. We don't need that. So for now, let's just add a simple text of hello world. That's fine. So what do we need right over here? Well, we actually kind of need to replicate what we have over here. So we are going to need a few stuff. First of all, let me just create that simple button. So a button, and I'm going to use the one with the action and label, so it will be really flexible. Action and the label. Now, for the label, I don't want to set it up over here inside the navigation sheet. I want to be able to create my own label. So I'm going to create a property right over here. It will be a view builder. View builder. And because I just want to have the ability to add vertical stacks and all of that stuff, private var, because I'm going to create a custom initializer. And then we are going to have a label, and that will be a completion of type label. And we want to set this up right over here, because this label that I just copy and pasted is of type view, needs to be of type view. Now I can use it. So label, just like that, with a small L. There we go. Now that label will be moved into our buttons label. Now, the same goes for the onDismiss and the destination. So let me just create the destination first. And I'm just going to duplicate this and say destination and destination. Okay, we're going to use the destination when we are setting up the sheet. Now, there is an onDismiss on the sheet. So let me just have here, sheet is presented and onDismiss. You see, here is our completion. Now, let's do that also as a property. So I would just add that as the third one. So private var onDismiss. And we have... That's really great. The auto-completion is suggesting a good completion right over here. Great. Now, let's just add that right over here, dot sheet is presented with the onDismiss, and then is presented. We want to put a state variable. We had that is presented right over here. Let me just copy that out and actually paste it in there, and I'm going to remove the destination view. Is presented. Now I'm just going to simply add it there. Is presented. OnDismiss, that's onDismiss. Content, well, that is our destination. So that's where we want to navigate to. Now, how do we trigger it? And I believe I have to add a dollar sign right over here. Yeah, let's just fix that. We are triggering it by tapping on the button. So we say is presented dot toggle. And that's it. Believe it or not, this is the simplest way of doing it. Of course, these are all private, so we need to create a custom initializer. So let's just use that. Init, I'm just going to use this one, and then let's just refactor that. So the destination is presented. We don't need that. It has to be private, only for this view. Destination, we do need that, but that needs to be a view builder. There we go. Destination escaping, and this is of type destination label. The label also has to be a view builder, so let me just copy that. Let's have that in on a new line, and then onDismiss on a new line too. Let's just hit Control I over there, and this has to be a label. Yeah, I know, a lot of changes, but you know, we have to make them because auto completion is not always correct. Okay, so is presented, we want to remove that, we don't need that. Okay, and that's our custom initializer. Let's just see how that looks like. So let's try to replicate this sheet. I'm going to comment it out, and we would say, navigation sheet, there we go. And then we would just choose destination and a label, or optionally an onDismiss. Let's just choose this one with the onDismiss so we can see how it looks like. Let's hit return twice, and then the destination will be the destination view. Let me just copy and paste it in. Our label will be a text of sheet. And on dismiss, let's just print out dismissed. That's fine. So now let's see how this sheet works. Sheet, destination view has been presented inside the sheet. And if I just scroll down, we would have, here we go, under the preview, we have the dismissed printed out. Now, how much better is this? We have the navigation link with the destination and label. Of course, the onDismiss is not working with the navigation link. That's, you know, from SwiftUI. But, you know, in SwiftUI camp, we are going to tackle also that. And we have the navigation sheet with the destination and the label. And, of course, with the onDismiss. Now, if you did like this tutorial, there's more in SwiftUI camp. Go ahead and check out the link in the description for an 80% discount for the first 5 students. See you then.